Welcome back to Growing Craft. Please do subscribe to our channel before we start this video and do not forget to hit the bell icon so that you do not miss out any of our updates. Also do check our website www.growingcraft.com and let's get started.
This side Sonia here from Growing Craft and we are so happy to be back with another session. And yes, like we always say that yes, we want to create something beautiful. We want to come up with something really interesting. So yes, today we are going to have a beautiful session on with these beautiful decoupage papers. And first of all, I'm really sorry, we had mentioned that we are going to come live on our YouTube channel, but because of some reasons we could not come live on our YouTube channel. But no worries, here we are with another tutorial on our Facebook page, and I hope you all are going to join us. One request, there was one amazing follower who had commented on one of my YouTube video, which we really loved it, and we have posted regarding connecting with us so that we can share some goodies with that particular person. So yes, please do check our YouTube channel post so that you know that we have something special for you today. Okay, now I hope you all can see me. Just let me know in the comment section if you all can see me, hear me carefully so that I can start with the session. And yes, I can already see few people here. Hi Kuljeet, hi Karuna, hello Natika, hello Bhavna, hi Isha. I'm so happy and I'm so glad. I was really worried because we had mentioned YouTube channel, but for some reason we were not able to join from there. Now, first of all, I have this amazing news to share it with you all, that now Growing Craft also has decoupage papers, MDF pieces. We are soon going to come up with the resin embellishments also. And yes, this is one of the paper collection what you had seen on my unboxing video. If you have not seen the unboxing video on my YouTube channel, please do check that. And I'm pretty sure you all are going to love this. So this is one of my favorite decoupage papers from the collection what we have on our website. We absolutely love this one. I totally love this one, and that's the reason I thought of doing a video tutorial with something new today. Like every time we do decoupage papers, transfer me sheet, of course those are like one of the amazing products, but using this for our session was something which I really wanted to, and especially on a tray, because whenever it comes to tray, we are always like we do typical prints and all. So yeah, just to bring a little change, I thought of doing something beautiful. So I have to pick up a beautiful napkin. So this was a really difficult process, and I have picked up this paper. All these supplies are there on our YouTube channel. All the links are mentioned in the comment section by our team members. You can check that right now. I'm just trying to remove all the excessive white borders from the sheets. These are not posters, these are decoupage papers. These are super thin papers, and yes, we really love this one. And I'm just trying to remove all the excessive white parts so that we can start sticking this on our base. Okay, so here I'm cutting this with my scissor. Now whenever I do my decoupage and my mixed media art, I usually try to make sure that we have a lot of things around me, like my gesso, my chalk paints, my acrylic paints, my water container, my Anukul paint brushes and everything. And yes, this reminds me, we are having flat 15% discount on Anukul brushes on our website. The discount coupon is mentioned in the comment section. You can check that. Yes, this is absolutely gorgeous and beautiful, and I really love this one. So the day I had got this paper, I knew I have to create something beautiful out of it. So yeah, here I can see that this fits in really well like this, but on the sides I will have to cut this down. It's just that I don't want to get my bigger trimmer here. So here I'm using my paper trimmer. All the supplies links are mentioned. Of course, we have a giveaway with this session. We are going to give one of the stamp from our collection as a giveaway prize for this session. So what you need to do is you need to comment on any of our 10 YouTube videos, and you also need to share this session as much as you can on, like, in public mode, of course, and in different Facebook groups. This is just to make sure that our tutorials are available with most of the people out there, so that you can try it out. Also, we have a Facebook group where you can share your artwork. If you ever got inspired from any of our artwork, if you have shared it on my Facebook group, definitely we are going to consider that for sure. Now, just a bit more trimming this off paper. Now, many of you have been asking me that why I need to use chalk paints every time, why I keep on using chalk paints for almost all my projects. That is because of the kind of finish it has. Okay, so yes, chalk paints make your work much more easier, and it lasts definitely for a longer time, and it is very, very good for doing your decoupage and your mixed media art. Please do not forget that we have flat 15% off on Anukul brushes. And yes, of course, there are interrupt, like, on your first purchase, you have flat 10% off on our complete store. So all these decoupage papers and other mediums, they are on sale on our website. Okay, so I am going to take up a plastic sheet because I really can't find my acrylic blocks right now. Why I need my sheet is because I have to blend in some of the colors. Now, today we are going to do our decoupage work in a little different way. I'll tell you how. Okay, usually what we do is we apply a lot of gesso and then we start working on our bases. So today what we are going to do is, today we are going to mix up our gesso and our acrylic paint. I know you must be thinking that Sonia has gone really crazy. So the gesso is this one. It is there at Amazon on a huge sale. So you can check that. The links are mentioned in the comment section, of course. And now I'm going to mix up my colors. Okay. So here, what I have taken is my chalk paint. And I'll take some more of my chalk paint. Please do share this session, and yes, comment on any 10 of our YouTube videos, and one lucky winner is going to get a goodie from us. So please, please, please don't miss out this opportunity of participating in our giveaway. Now, just in case if you guys have any query, you can let me know in the comment section. I will be more than happy to help you all. Okay, now as you can see here, I'm adding my gesso to my chalk paint. I know this looks like a process, it's just that because my chalk paint was drying out. So this is also a good way to revive your chalk paints. We just need to add some amount of water and it works out perfectly. Okay, I'm almost done. Now you can see my color has changed, and this is actually turned out to be the perfect color which I was looking for. Let me add a bit tinge of green color more, because I know I will be needing a lot of color for this tray, because this tray is quite huge. Now if you check our website, we have trays also, we have MDF posters also, decoupage papers also. The paper whatever we are going to use today is there on our website. The website link is growingcraft.com, and we also have a discount on our collections. So to check our discounts, you need to connect with us on our WhatsApp number. I'll just wet my brush a bit and I'll start applying this on my base. As you can see, my tray has already started taking up such a beautiful shade. Okay. And I was doing it in the center because I wanted to show you guys that how it looks. But honestly, I don't need to do it on the center. Why? Because anyways, we are going to stick our paper there. Okay. So I'll just keep on doing my coloring and spread it really well. So what we have used here is a white gesso and our chalk paint. Now, whichever the extra lumps are there, I'll just keep that aside and we'll start doing coloring on the other sides too. Now, as I'm applying my colors, you can see that the color is changing. Why? Because like I had said that my chalk paint was drying out. So to revive that, I have added a bit of water, and of course I have added white color gesso because I wanted to have a little more color on the top of it. Yes, do avail the discounts on our supplies. What you need to do is you need to connect with us on WhatsApp. You can check our website. All the details are mentioned there. Okay. So yeah, this looks great. I actually love this green color, and adding my white gesso has actually brightened this up a little more, which is looking great. So very recently on our YouTube channel, we have started doing a lot of paper crafting tutorials also. You can check that too. Also with the massive stamps, we are coming up with few more designs very, very soon. So that means we are going to have a lot of giveaway on our channels also. So yes, you guys need to be stay tuned to our channel a lot now. Yeah, can you see this green color? This looks gorgeous. This looks really, really beautiful. Okay, now this is done. Now on the outer side, I'm going to do the same process. A tinge of water on my brush, and I'm going to spread this. Now while applying, you can see that there are some of the particles. This is because of the dried chalk paint, but you can easily revive your chalk paints. And how you can do that, I have just shown you. Try this out and I'm sure you are going to love this, and it is going to work out for you guys also. Now for drying this, I am going to use my heat gun. If you guys don't have a heat gun, you can use your hair dryer. But of course, there is a difference, so just keep that in mind, and I'm sure you guys can use that also. Thank you so much, Payal Mittal, for sharing this. Yeah, so here I am just trying to apply my colors as quickly as I can. See, I could have done this step earlier also, like off camera, but I wanted to show you guys that how you can revive your chalk paints. Now, it's with almost all the brands that the chalk paints, over the time, they start drying out. Even though they are in an airtight container, it happens. But then it's not that then you need to throw that out. Why? Because it is super easy to revive your paints, acrylic paints, your chalk paints. I have also done a video on how to revive your paints and your how to like take care of your brushes, and all those videos are there on our YouTube channel. Yes, so here we are almost done. See, now usually if I don't use my heat gun, it is going to take good amount of time to dry this out, and that means I'm going to get an ample amount of time to work with my paints. So that's the beauty of the winters, when you really need time to dry these things out. I have used a chalk paint and I have also used my white gesso. Okay, and now I'm going to dab my sponge dauber just to make sure that it takes up a nice effect on the base. This is my sponge dauber. This is one of my favorite tools, which I feel that it should be there with almost all the mixed media and decoupage artists. So just in case if you don't have it, please do buy this one. This is going to solve like most of your problems with the paints for sure. Now here what I'm going to do is I'll just dab my sponge dauber in water and then on my paint. This is just to make sure that I have a nice blending effect on my tray. My color should look very much natural. Yeah, so I'm going to dab it here. Don't take too much of water, don't take too less water, and start dabbing it. Just in case if you guys have any query, you can comment on any of our YouTube videos and I will be more than happy to help you all. Okay, so I'm almost done. Now we are going to repeat the process on the sides. This is just to make sure that the background becomes smooth and easy to work on. I hope my screen is visible. I hope my tutorial is clear. Just in case if you guys have any doubt, you can comment on our YouTube videos. And yes, we are doing a lot of videos on your mixed media art on clay, and all those tutorials are absolutely free on our YouTube channel. You can check that too. Okay, so here we are done. We are really done with our work. I'll just dab some paint on the top side so that we cover this portion also. Now, if you want, you can do the contrast coloring also. It's absolutely fine. And if you want, you can play around with two shades also. Three shades also. It depends on kind of color combination you are looking for. Okay, so I'm just very quickly dabbing my chalk paint and my gesso. So this is actually going to save me a lot of time of first applying the gesso. Of course, the color combinations and everything is going to be completely different. So you need to know like what exactly you're looking for, and then accordingly you need to plan out your artwork. So here I am almost done. By the time, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my heat gun to start drying it up, because I know it's going to take a lot of time for this much area to dry out. So for the coloring, what I have used is my chalk paint and my gesso. Just in case if you have missed out on the session, like what I have used, all the supplies are listed in the comment section. You can check that. Yes, you can absolutely use the acrylic paints, but there is a huge difference in acrylic paint and chalk paints. What is the difference? You can check that on our YouTube channel. We have already done a session which shows the difference between your chalk paints and your acrylic paints. See, knowing your color is really important. Knowing the kind of shades what you are using is really, really important. Now, very quickly, let me just clean up my brushes so that they don't get damaged. Okay. Yeah, so here I am done. Now I will start with my decoupage sheet. Now before doing the decoupage work, I will just try to make sure that if there is anything excessive, any particles or anything on my tray, I'll just try to remove that. Okay, I don't have to be very rough, because it's easily going to come out. Tap anything excessive you have on your bases. Again, I'll just run my heat gun to make sure that it dries out well. Yeah, this is almost done. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to have my Mod Podge. This is like one of the best thing what you can have for your decoupage work. And I will start applying this on my base. Now I will be starting from one corner, and we have to make sure that we apply this on all the sides. Okay, and here it is. This looks great. The color is looking really great, and I am hoping that my decoupage paper will also look fab with this color combination. Yeah, okay, so now I'm done with my decoupage glue, and now very quickly I'll take up a nice flat clean brush and I'll start sticking my decoupage paper. Okay, so yeah, I think I'm almost, yes, so I have tried to leave the equal amount of gap on both the sides, and I'll just pull this paper down. I'll take up one more palette knife to take it out, and I'll start from one of the portions from the top. Okay, I'll take up another sponge dauber, and now I'll start sticking this on my base. I hope this is visible. And can you see this? This tray already looks so amazing. I'll just press this well so that if there is any wrinkles or bubbles, it will just settle down very quickly. And on the edges, it should stick very, very nicely. Okay. So this looks gorgeous. Now I'll take a palette knife, I'll just stick it nicely on the edges, because we want to make sure that on the edges it settles down well. And can you see this? Yeah, there are no wrinkles, there are no bubbles, and it's looking gorgeous and beautiful. Now again I'm going to take another sponge dauber, and I'll start pressing this from the sides. Okay, now of course on the edges my colors are wet, so it is just going to blend in a bit on my paper, which is absolutely fine with me. Okay, ye bahut important step hai. You have to make sure that it presses down really well. Do participate in our giveaway, share this session as much as you can, and comment on 10 of our videos. And yes, of course, one lucky winner is going to get a goodie from us. And yes, all the decoupage papers, trays and everything, all the supplies are there. It's available at Growing Craft Store. So yes, you can definitely check that. Now I hope you liked this one. Now it's time to add a little more drama here. So what we are going to do is, now here I have one more shade of chalk paint and I will start coloring this on my base. Okay, now this is an orange color shade. Let me take up another brush. Okay, yeah, I'll take up this one. Today we have flat 15% discount on our Anukul brushes, so please do check our store and you can get the coupon links from the comment section. And all these Decopart supplies are available at our store. We are also sharing the Amazon link, so you can check it from both this ways, and I hope you are going to like it. Now, can you see a nice contrast orange color we are doing? Now, for doing this, I am taking my paint brush and I am using my chalk paint. Okay. And this looks great. So we are going to repeat this process. Now if you want, you can do your stencil work, but on the top part I wanted to have my nice base work of chalk paint. That's why I first did my green color chalk paint, and right now I am doing my orange color chalk paint on the top of it. If you don't have chalk paints, you can use your acrylic paints, but look and feel is going to be completely different. Keep that in mind. That's very important, because acrylic paints and chalk paints, they are two complete different things. Okay, now I also have got a nice wood stain color recently, and I'm thinking of using that on my base. This looks gorgeous. This is looking absolutely beautiful. So can you imagine, earlier it was just a plain tray what we had, the plain natural MDF tray, and now we have literally transformed into a quirky tray. Okay, all these papers and trays and supplies are available on our website, and we also have some of the discounts on a few of the supplies, so do check that. Like today we have flat 15% discount, and yes, you need to stay tuned to our YouTube channel, because we are coming up with some of the amazing tutorials on that. So yes, we had recently associated with few of the very good Indian craft supply brands, and I'm sure you are going to love all those tutorials. Okay, so yes, here I am done with my orange color chalk paint, right? And I hope this is visible to you guys. This looks great. Like, this looks absolutely amazing. Now what we need to do is, we need to move on to the next work, that is our stencil work. So let me pick up a stencil quickly and I have decided that I'm going to use which stencil now. Okay, now this is the stencil which I will be using. So we are going to play around with the contrast coloring. Okay, so I'll keep a jar beneath this. I will have my stencil. I'll have my stencil brush. I have taken up my color here. Okay, and I'll just rub on all the excessive color on my craft mat. I can clean this craft mat later on. Let me upside. Okay, so here we are not going to cover the complete tray. Here we are just going to do a bit of portion of the tray. Okay, Can you see this? And we are going to repeat this pattern here. Just a tinge of coloring work. We don't have to overdo this at all. Yes, and can you see this? Yeah, this looks great. Let me switch off the light. I'm not sure if this is visible. No, I think with the light only this was clear. Yeah, okay, so this is how it looks from one of the portions. Now I'm going to repeat this on the other sides too. Just take up all the excessive colors from the top. And with the stencil brush, you need to do this. Isn't it looking great? This looks gorgeous. Now we are going to repeat this on all the four sides. Just a tinge of chalk paint. If you don't have a chalk paint, you can even use your acrylic paints. It's absolutely fine. And I'm just doing this work on some of the parts of the tray. Like I'm not doing this on the complete tray. And this is the last side. Do participate in our giveaway. We have decided to give our stamp, one of the massive stamp, as a giveaway prize. For that, what you need to do is you need to join our giveaway, and to join that you need to share this session as much as you can, and you need to also comment on any 10 of our YouTube videos and let us know in that comment that what you liked in that video. We just don't want one word comment for sure, because that is not the agenda for us. The main thing why we want you guys to comment and let us know is that we should know that why you like that particular video. That is way more important for us to know. Now here, so now here we are going to use our checkered stamp, and I'm going to use my ink pad, not my ink pad but my chalk paint. So here with my same brush, I am dabbing my colors on my stamp, just doing it like this, and now I'm going to stamp it on the borders. Okay, I just need a very thin mark, and can you see this? This looks great. We are going to repeat the same process on all the sides of the tray, just on only on the borders. Okay, see, this is how you can use the massive stamps, and do it on your any of the MDF bases. Like you can repeat the same process for your trays, for your nameplates. I have already used these stamps a lot many times for my background stamping, and they work out perfectly. See, this is how you need to place your stamp with your chalk paint and do it on your bases. Can you see this? Yes. And I absolutely love this background stamping with the massive stamps. All these stamps are available on our website, Growing Craft. You can definitely check these two. And we are almost done. Ta-da, ta-da, ta-da. Yeah, so here our tray is ready. This looks gorgeous. This looks beautiful. And I really hope that you all enjoyed this session. Now I need to varnish this up, but before that I need to dry this up for almost 2 hours, and then only I'll varnish it, because we have done a lot of color blending today, and definitely we want this to dry out completely. So this is my stamping work. This is not my stencil work. So yes, even with the massive stamps, you can do these kind of background work. On the sides, I have done this stencil work. You can check that. And I'm sure you guys are going to love, love, love this one. Now, regarding the giveaway, many of you had queries that we have commented on our video, YouTube videos. But why I was not selected? See, it's not all about commenting just one word. You need to let us know why you like that video. You need to mention that at least in a one or two lines. The second thing is you need to share our Facebook page tutorials and post in different Facebook groups. That is really going to help us to reach to more number of people, and that is the reason why we love having giveaways. So yes, please do consider that. And not only just by commenting on YouTube videos, you also need to share, like I mentioned, share our Facebook post in different groups. And yes, you need to follow us on our Facebook page. So you need to click on follow button, and then only you will be eligible for the giveaway winning prize if you are lucky. Okay, and I hope this is clear. Just in case if you guys have any query, please do let me know on any of our YouTube channel post, and we will be more than happy to help you all. And I really, really hope that you all enjoyed this session. Please do share this as much as you can. And yes, one lucky winner is going to get one of the stamps from Massive Store, and that's absolutely free for one of the lucky winners. What you need to do is comment on 10 of our YouTube videos and share this session, this particular session, as much as you can. And thank you so much for watching, guys. Take care. Bye bye.